Hey, how's it going, everybody? Welcome to Free Beat, where I post new music-related content every single day. So if that sounds good to you, hit that subscribe button, ring that notification bell. Let's get started. Today, we've got the Arturia Microfreak alongside the Korg NTS-1, and I'm going to show you guys how to sync these two devices up. So to some of you, this might seem a bit basic, but I know that there's some first-time Microfreak users out there, some first-time NTS-1 users out there, and maybe some first-time synthesizer users out there, because this is a very powerful and fairly low budget setup. So I figured I would make this video just so there's no confusion, just to show you guys directly how to sync the internal sequencer and arpeggiator on the Microfreak with the internal arpeggiator of the NTS-1. So the first thing we're gonna wanna do is power on both of our devices. So for that, we plug in the NTS-1 to USB. And for the Microfreak, we simply turn on the power switch with it plugged into the wall. I'm going to plug in my audio interface to the audio out of the NTS-1. Perfect. Now I'm going to take a standard 1/8-inch cable and plug this into the headphone output of my Arturia Microfreak. And then I'm going to plug this into the audio in on the Korg NTS-1. And now we have audio passing through from the Microfreak through the NTS-1. So now we can use the effects of the NTS-1. So here's the disrespectful patch with some reverb on it. Pretty cool. Let's put a little delay on there. And some flanger. Just because we can. So that's the most basic way to connect these to each other. But what if we want to go one step further and sync the two clocks together? Well, it's pretty easy. All you're gonna need is one additional 1/8-inch cable. And how we're gonna do this is we are going to once again go to the back of our Microfreak, and we are going to go to the clock in and out section right here. We're gonna go to the clock out of the Microfreak. We're going to take the other end of that cable and we're going to insert that into the sync in of the NTS-1. Just like that. Now the clocks are synced. So I'm going to turn off the effects on the NTS-1. Then I'm going to pick a different preset here on the Microfreak. There we go. Just a standard square wave. How about that? Cool. So now this knob right here becomes our BPM. So on the NTS-1, if we press and hold the arpeggiator button until it says latch, now we can start the arpeggiator. You're not going to hear anything. That's because the Microfreak is not sending an output, a sync signal yet. We need to first turn on our arpeggiator, and then we can adjust the tempo with this knob here. I'm going to go to 120. So now, when I hold this note down, it's sending the sync signal. And the NTS-1 will continue. We can filter that down a little. We can actually hold these with the hold button there. We can increase the tempo. Sounds pretty neat. We can put some reverb on there. Probably no delay, that'll get pretty hectic. Mess with the oscillator shape. Mess with the filtering. And just generally play with these how we'd like. Of course, we can change the note as well. I'm going to stop that real quick and then press the ARP to stop it. There's different arpeggiator types that we can select as well. So if we hold down the arpeggiator button, we can select with the type knob here. We can select random, which I just did. So we can hear it's just playing random notes. So I'm just going to start playing now on the Microfreak. Thank you. So now I have the release set on both of these to basically off. So they're very, very staccato, very punchy. Which is super cool. You can also do this with the sequencer. Sounds like there's already a sequence in there right now. So that's cool. I'm gonna hold the arpeggiator button, arm it for playback. Press play there. And now the NTS-1 is playing as well. Of course, we can like play little solos over the top of this as well. Which doesn't sound too good right here. This was just a really easy patch to use for an example. But as you can hear, as we adjust the tempo, the two of these devices are synced up and working properly. Feel free to explore to your heart's content. There's a lot you can do here. This was just kind of a basic video showing you how to hook these two up. If you would prefer to have the NTS-1 as the master start and stop button, you can always switch the sync in to the sync out on here and the clock out to the clock in on here. And then when you hold down the arpeggiator button and press a note on the keyboard, then it will start the clock send to the Microfreak rather than how we just did it, which was the exact opposite. So I hope this video was helpful to you. If it was, go ahead and leave a like on it. If not, you can leave a dislike. That's okay too. Doesn't hurt my feelings, just makes me try that much harder next time. Either way, be sure to hit that subscribe button, ring that notification bell, help us out on the climb to 1700 subscribers. Thanks so much for being here. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Bye.